Hello everyone, my name is Neeraj and I'm the part of Kepro open source platform working as a cloud infrastructure lead. Today I'm going to discuss about S3 storage class. Before that, I have already released one video regarding AWS S3 bucket and its creation. And in that we have seen while uploading the object there is an option for a storage class. For that we are going to discuss today. So let's start. In this video, we are going to discuss S3 storage class, use of Amazon Glacier, S3 bucket lifecycle management, and the lab on storage class as well as a lifecycle management. So the S3 storage class will be categorized depend upon the object accessibility pattern. Means that as per the object access pattern, the storage class has been classified into three parts. One is storage class for frequently accessed object, storage class for infrequently accessed object, and the storage class for object at rest or archive. So suppose you have a bucket and you want to upload an object. So while uploading the object, if you know that what is going to be in a pattern of this object, here the object means file. So you are going to discuss like what would be the pattern of the file, then you can choose your storage class according to that. If you think that you have a frequently accessed object, so you can choose the class belong to that. You think that no, not every day, but someday whenever there is a need, it is need in emergency, so you can choose a storage class infrequent access. Or if you want, if you think that no, I'm just putting the file or object for a long term and it need once in a 6 month or once in a year, you can put in you can choose archive class for the storage class for the archive. So the storage class for frequently accessed object, what are that? Standard storage class, reduced redundancy standard, and then intelligent tiering storage class. The storage class available for infrequent access object will be standard IA, means IA means infrequent access. So standard IA storage class, one zone IA storage class. If you have a storage class, you are looking for archive, we have a Glacier storage class. So let's go in a detail. So the storage class for frequently accessed object. First, we have discussed about S3 standard, or you can say standard storage class. So this is a default storage class. Whenever you will upload an object and you are not defining any object class, it will go to the storage class. And this is highly available, reliable, everything is required it has. So this is a default storage class. If you don't specify the storage class when you upload an object, the Amazon S3 assign the standard storage class. Okay, and the second one is reduce redundancy. So the reduce redundancy is similar to the S3 standard, but multiple copies stored in the backend by the Amazon, so it will be reduced. Redundancy will be not, redundancy copy of the object will be not that much. So yes, this storage class is designed for non-critical reproducible data that can be stored with a less redundancy than a storage class, standard storage class. For durability, the reduced redundancy object RRS have an average annual expectation loss of 0.01% of the object. So do you think that anything associated with this? Yes, there is a cost. So you think that I have to keep a data that is frequently accessible, but I can reproduce the data? You should not go within a standard storage class because there is a cost. You can choose reduced redundancy and it is cheaper than the standard. Now there is a third one, intelligent tiering. Intelligent tiering is a newly introduced storage class, and that comes into picture in the case like you are uploading a lot of object and files, but you don't know the exact access pattern. So in that situation, you can choose intelligent tiering, because in intelligent tiering, it has a tier 1 and tier 2 in the backend. They have the kind of functionality. So they will, they, their engine will have an algorithm. They will choose that which file is mostly accessible, it will put in tier 1, and which file is less accessible, it will put in tier 2. Putting the file in, storing the file in tier 1 and tier 2 is the cost related, like tier 1 has a higher cost, tier 2 has a lower cost. But moving the files from tier 1 to tier 2 and from tier 2 to tier 1, that doesn't require any cost and it doesn't impact any performance. Like you are trying to access a file that internally by intelligent tiering class, if you choose that it is present in tier 2 because it was not frequently accessed, and you have to, and you are looking now, it will be available. It's nothing like that, there will be a delay. So this is the newly introduced storage class. So the optimize storage cost by automatically moving data to the most cost effective storage access tier without performance impact or operational overhead. This storage class is ideal for long live data when the access pattern is unknown or unpredictable. As I told, the two access tier, one is tier 1 for frequent and another lower cost tier for infrequent access data. So the in storage class for frequently accessed object, we have a three as the standard, reduced redundancy and intelligent tiering. Now come to the storage class for infrequent access object. We have a standard IA. Standard IA is very simpler. As you store the object in a redundant across multiple geographically separated available zone. It is very similar to standard storage class, but cost is bit lower. And you can put the data which is not frequently accessed. Use for your primary or only copy of data that cannot be recreated. Means that if you have a data you think it cannot be recreated, but I want to looking for some cheaper resource, but I want whenever I want it should available, you can choose a standard IA. Now, second is one zone IA. One zone IA is very similar to the reduced redundancy, but yes, there will be a data loss chance. As to store the object data only in one availability zone, which make it less expensive than a standard IA. And the storage class is durable as a standard IA, but less available and less resilient. Means that if there could be a chance of loss, so you can only put the data that you feel that it will be recreatable, like some temporary staging you want, or putting the data for your analytics purpose, or some system log you want to put, you can put it. So what are the common points here for both the storage? Object are available for millisecond access, means that whenever you will try to look for the record will be, record or means the file will be available, is nothing like that, there will be a delay. You can move your data if you plan to store at least for 30 days, means that if you're going to choose a standard IA or one zone IA or storage class for infrequent access object, you have to store data at least for 30 days. So what will happen if you delete your data before 30 days or moved out your data before 30 days? Nothing, but you have to pay for the 30 days. If you delete an object before 30 days minimum, you are charged for 30 days. So in your billing, it will come for the 30 days. Even you keep for 20 days, it will come for the 30 days. Now, storage class for data at rest, and that is archive. And for that, Amazon Glacier. You can see my first video, the video which is introduction of a storage class. I have already mentioned like Amazon Glacier. We can use in two way. Either you can use an storage class or you can use as an storage service. So here we are going to discuss about how to use a storage class in S3. So the Glacier storage class is suitable for archiving data where data is access is infrequent, and also if you store your data in the Glacier, it is not available for the real time. It is cheapest you can say like source of storing data. So all the point we'll discuss here. The Glacier storage class offer the same durability and resiliency as the standard storage class. Glacier archived object are not available for the real time. I told you, you must first restore the Glacier object before you can access them. Means if you upload your data to Amazon Glacier, and if you want to fetch some record, or if you want to open the file, you can't open it. You have to restore. And it will be restored to any temporary storage class that is called reduced redundancy. So if you store a file in Amazon Glacier and if you want to restore, the file will be copied, not moved. So in the billings, it will come as a storage for two places. The same file will be stored in the two places, and for both the two places, whatever the storage cost, it will come. I will show you. Now there is, sorry, restored action completion can be notified using Amazon S3 event. Yes, yeah, event notification you can set with S3. Restored copy is stored in RRS, reduced redundancy storage, and original copy will be always present in Glacier unless you delete it manually. I told you, it will, when you restore is not moving of the object or file, it will be copy the file into temporary to in your any storage class, and you have to pay for both the storage. Yes, you have to pay for the both the storage stored copy as well as the original copy. Now I told how to retrieve. If you store it, the retrieval is a three options. Okay, in the normal case is 3 to 5 hours it will take to retrieve, but there could be an emergency, so an obvious options are associated with the cost. So you have an Glacier where the object archive to Amazon Glacier are not accessible in real time. You must first initiate the restore and then wait until a temporary copy of object is available for the duration that you specify in the request. And the time it takes to restore the job complete depend upon which retrieval option you have specified. So I told you there are some options to specify. The first is expedited, that is required real time, like 1 to 5 minutes, but there is a cost associated with that. Now, second one is standard, that is by default, but it takes allow you to access archive object. A standard retrieval typically complete in 3 to 5 hours. These are the default options. Okay, it doesn't specify the need retrieval option, by default it will take. Now the another one is bulk. The bulk one, it says it is a Glacier, the lowest cost retrieval. Okay, you can store a petabyte of data. Bulk retrieval typically takes 5 to 12 hours. That is. So storage classes use case. So storage classes use case means that storage we have broadly divided into storage class for frequently access, a storage class for infrequently access, and a storage class for archive data. So the storage class means active data. The use case is for the general purpose storage, you can use it. Big data analytics, content distribution for the static web hosting. If you are using your S3 bucket, you can choose this standard storage class. For infrequent, as a standard infrequent storage class, you can choose for your backup and archive, disaster recovery files that you want to store. You want to store the file sync and sharing, I mean a copy of file you want to be available, or long retained data. For the Glacier, you have a long-term archival, digital preservation, and magnetic tape replacement. Means that you have a lot of binary files or software files in a terabyte or software hub you want to create, you can put in Glacier. You have a lot of tape backups, you know, that required 7 years of data to be stored, 6 years of data, financial record for taxation purpose, once in a year for the retrieval you required. Remove the magnetic tape dependency, you put in the Glacier. So these are the normal use case for the each and every storage class. Now, till now we have gone through the storage class for active, or you can say infrequent, and then that is archive kind of things. And for that, there is a new things in a bucket called object lifecycle management, where we have to, if we have uploaded the file, we can define how the file will be transit, like tomorrow if the file is getting less accessible, can we move from one storage class to another storage class. Yes, lifecycle configuration is a set of rules that you can define on S3 bucket and apply to all the object present in the bucket. And it has a transaction kind of action, like where the object in transition from one storage class to another, And if you want that after 2 years the file should get deleted, it will delete or expire automatically. And how to define the job expiration. So life cycle is mainly for the two purpose: how to rotate a storage class, okay, and how to do the expiration. Like suppose you are using for a use case where a lot of log files are coming, and you are using for your analyzing the file for your own your analytic or whatever the job you have put for that purpose. After some time, that file is not in use. So can we move to, can we create a cycle for that? Like it will go to the lower cost storage class, and then we'll go to the lower, further lower storage class. And after that, if you want to purge automatically, you can say purging automatically, we can set it. Sorry. Now we'll go on. We'll go to lab. See this. I have logged in through Caput training. So I can, if you want, again, I can show you, we can go to S3. Actually, I was already there in S3, but we can go to S3, Capro demo 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. I have created that bucket already in my last video. The object can be public. So I'm not going to discuss about public and private again. Now I will upload a file. Last time, whatever I have uploaded, I have cleaned that. I have uploaded the file. I will go with an hello text. I will upload it and see this. I will go to next. I'll go to next. See. If I'm not going to choose, it will automatically deselect the standard. Frequently accessed data designed for availability zone. More than 3 availability zone, this will be available. Intelligent tiering, long-lived data for which charging, changing or unknown access pattern, minimum storage 30 days, per object fee apply. So here you can choose it. Okay, so suppose I am choosing an intelligent tiering. Okay, we are putting upload. Now it is in, upload is in process. Now successfully uploaded. Now I am in the Capro demo bucket. Now we'll go to management. We'll go to life cycle. If you want, we'll create on the life cycle. We'll create a rule. So you can put it my Capro rule. I'm just typing, leave the prefix. I want to show you that cycling. See, I have not enabled the versioning. We have not come across it, so we are not going to discuss. So always choose current version because you have versioning is not yet enabled. So the storage class transition. You can add rule in the life cycle configuration to tell Amazon S3 to the transit. So why I'm putting like this is add the transition. Like suppose I have uploaded the file hello text. Okay, it will be accessed by the users, and after a month or 2 months and 3 months, because it is in cost associated, I feel that file is not that much of use. That I feel system will not fill. I feel that's the reason I'm going to tell the system that object creation after how many days. Like object creation means uploading the object in S3 bucket. I've already chosen the intelligent tiering. Okay, so after so transition to Amazon Glacier, after 1 day creation, no, after 60 days. So you can't directly put it in creation. I mean, that is also not recommended. Like you want to transit to the standard IA or transit to intelligent tiering. The interesting part is that if you upload, the S3 bucket is not here. Sorry, S3 standard is not here, because by default always the AWS think that object is available in by default. After that, if you have put any object in here, it will be there only. But after certain time, if you want to move in a lower, it will go to lower, it will not go in backward. Means that once you can tell your file will come in a standard IE after some 30 days. Suppose I'm putting after 30 days, it can come. Now I can put one more transition. Like after 30 days, it will come to the Glacier. After 60 days, I can put 360 days. 360. So after creation, like first time when the file was put in the bucket, after 30 days it should move to standard IA infrequent access or transition to Amazon Glacier after 360 days. Now if I go, suppose I'm selecting, if I go next, configuration expiration. Do you want configuration expiration? Yes, I want. Okay, expiration after how many days do you want to clean multiple, leave this multi-upload. You want to clean the expire object, version of the object. If you want to delete, an option will come also. Current expiration version of the object. Clean up the expire object, delete marker and complete multipar. You can click that. See, expiration will clean all the object if you put previous one also. And clean up multipart. Multipart means like if you are uploading any file in parallelly and it got break. So half is updated in the bucket, half is not. So you can, it will clean that also. So this kind of things you can set permanently, delete the previous version after this much day. So all this thing you can set it. You can again select, save. See, my rule action will be current IE Amazon Glacier expire permanently, delete previous version. Sorry. So it is set here. So see this storage class intelligent tiering. Suppose I have to upload a file. Okay, I will show that. Now I will go to Hello Text Part 2. I will choose it. Go to the next. See the storage class. Okay, if I can say that it can go to this one, it will go. Whichever you want, it will go. While uploading, you can select it. Now, by mistake, while uploading the file, I choose the storage class is one zone IA. Now, I have done a wrong selection. So from here, I cannot move my file from one storage class to another for this object. So what I have to do is either I have to re-upload the same file. It is called overwrite put. The same file you can re-upload. But at that time you can choose, see this, one time ozone IA, again I will upload the same file. Again I will upload the Hello Text Part 2, same file. But this time because I had done a mistake, I will choose intelligent or I will put as a standard or a standard IA suppose. I will click here, see this successful. So if you are uploading an object and by mistake you have chosen a wrong storage class, you have to re-upload it. There is no other option internally, like you can move your object from one storage class to another. Now, I told you like in S3 manage, if you go to in S3 bucket, you can create the life cycle that we have told, that go to the standard IA, after some time it will go to the Glacier. Now you might have a question, I have a zip file, can I upload directly to the S3 Glacier standard, the Glacier class? Choose the part file 3. I will show you. So here we can go and choose. Let's try. I'm choosing the Glacier. So you have, if you have, okay, this is for cross region replication, then leave it. It is saying that if you have enabled cross region replication, that Glacier storage class won't replicate. So it is talking about that. So I'm directly uploading to the standard, uploading it in a Glacier. What happened? Yeah, see this. Hello Text Part 3 come as a Glacier storage class. So if you know that, if you you have uploaded any bucket, you have a bucket, you have uploaded any object, object has an endpoint, it has an open download, can I download it? It will be, the icon will come to download. Because it is not public, I can make it public. Sorry. And I can click it. I can open it. See, welcome to the, it is able to download also. So that is belong this text for that is this is my hello text, because hello text belong to storage class intelligent ear. Standard IA will do the same, but if you click on a Glacier, see this, it is just present in a Glacier, so you cannot download it, you cannot open this link also. See, this is present object is in Glacier, you cannot download it, make it public, you cannot edit any property or permission. So what you have to do, that is the question. So go to the again bucket, in my bucket, click, select the only the third object, because the object is in Glacier. Now go to action, restore from Glacier, GI, restore from GL, Glacier, click here, see this, number of days the restored copy will be available. I want to put for 5 days. So restore tier, Glacier charge request fee and per GB retrieve fee, which barely based on the tier selection. So bulk retrieval, standard retrieval, expedited retrieval, that will take 1 to 5 minutes, but retrieval less than a minute when retrieving less than 250 MB. Let me try that. It is something cost associated. Okay, leave it. We'll try with a standard one. We'll restore. So restore is in process. See this. It is in progress. Restoration is in progress. So I can't open right now, and I think it will take some time to show you. So, oh my god, okay, restoration will take some time, it is in progress. So this is the way you can restore it. Once it will be restored, one more file will come here with the same name, and it will show here RR reduced redundancy. So this is the way it will work. Now we will go to our lab. So what we have learned in this lab, like we have a storage class, a standard designed for frequently accessed data. Durability is 11.9. You can just calculate it. 11.9 of durability. Ability is 4.9. Available more than 3 ability zone. Standard IA long live infrequent access data. Durability is 11.9. Ability is 999. And again, it is present in more than 3 ability zone, intelligent tiering, unknown access pattern, 11.9 of durability and 999 of availability, present again in more than 3 ability zone, 1 zone IA, long live infrequent access, non-critical data, 11.9 of durability, 99.5% of availability and present in only 1 available zone. Glacier, long-term data archiving with 11.9 of durability and 4.9 of availability, present in more than 3 ability zone. RR, reduced redundancy storage, infrequent access, non-critical, durable is 4.9 durability and 4.9 of ability, present in more than 3 ability zone. So this is how storage class works in S3, or we can use this storage class in S3 bucket, and how we can create a life cycle management of transition of a storage of the file as the time go according to the access pattern of the file. Now the next topic we are going to discuss about versioning of bucket that we have shown in that is resources, bucket resources, the versioning. So we are going to discuss versioning of the bucket, cross region replication, object operation and lab on it. Thank you. Let's keep learning. You can write us feedback to the feedback@thecapro.co.in. If you want to learn other technology of blockchain, cloud, data science, CTL, data lake, DevOps, big data testing and cloud testing, please follow us on YouTube, Facebook, LinkedIn and Twitter. Thank you again and let's keep learning.